In tonight's cover story, COVID psychosis.
Medical reporter Dina Barra helps you understand the life-altering condition.
After 2 years overwhelmed by the pandemic, frantically searching for information to save patients, the science is becoming more clear. Doctors are beginning to understand how the virus hijacks the brain. Answers some families have been craving since they were suddenly struck by the little-known COVID threat.
It was just our happy place out at the farm. It was, you know, a lot of work, but we had so much fun doing it together.
Jennifer and Ben Price had big plans for this peaceful stretch of property 70 miles southwest of Chicago.
We had our cows out there. That was our dream. That was where we were going to move and build our home.
Before they purchased the farm, they built a family.
He loved his children more than anything in this world.
The dad with big blue eyes and an even bigger smile got sick with COVID in February 2021. The 48-year-old was eventually hospitalized and given supplemental oxygen and steroids.
It was a very trying time for him. He loved being around people, and he was completely isolated.
After several days of inpatient care, Ben came home.
He was very weak, and he was still very sick. But within a few days was when we started noticing change in his behavior. His tone of voice was different. The look in his eyes was fear, and they were very wide, like he was scared. And he kept saying, "I'm just so scared."
It was for us like a cold, very mild symptoms.
Mac Davis and his wife tested positive for COVID in January 2021.
About 2 weeks after we got it, I started to feel great anxiety. It led into depression. You know, you ask anybody that knows me, and they still to this day can't believe that I became the person I did during that time.
The normally outgoing and affable Texas salesman.
Didn't want to see anybody. I was paranoid, did a lot of pacing around the house for no reason.
Ben did the same thing.
He was pacing the house. He was going from window to window, and he wasn't telling us anything. And the only thing he said at one point was, "I have so much farming to do. I have so much farming to do." And this was February, so there was no farming to be done.
In Houston, Mac's wife and son were so concerned about the 47-year-old's behavior, they hid the family's firearms.
She hid every gun but the gun that she had in her own car, and she just didn't think I was suicidal, and I hid that from her. But every day I would go in that garage, I'd grab that gun, and thank God I didn't do it.
5 days after Ben was released from the hospital, he drove out to the family farm.
He wasn't himself yet, but he seemed better. And he said, "You know, I just want to go out and do some paperwork because I feel like then I'm getting something done, and that helps me." Not long later, his dad was driving around looking at the farms and checking on the animals, and went out there and just couldn't find him. He saw his truck.
They tried to reach Ben on his phone. No answer.
His dad called me back, and he had found him, and he was gone. You know, there's just no way to prepare yourself for something like that. It was just never on our radar, even with how off he'd been. That was not even a question in our minds.
Just hours after Ben's suicide, a friend mentioned COVID psychosis and sent Jennifer articles about the condition.
And immediately upon reading them, I knew exactly that that's what he had experienced.
You see something?
The mother of Maya and Jet says her husband of 23 years had never suffered with mental illness, depression, or anxiety before getting infected. And the couple had always faced life's challenges together. She says they were unbreakable.
You know, our son was born extremely premature. He was only a pound and a half when he was born. He's almost 19 years old. So We've been through extreme stress. We've been through tough times.
The kinds of things that we're seeing really reflect profound changes in how brain circuitry is working.
It's not that the virus itself travels to the brain. Rather, it can trigger an aggressive immune response, what's called a cytokine storm. That results in widespread inflammation, the body's way to combat the virus. It's the same inflammatory process responsible for the severe lung damage seen in many patients during the pandemic. But the cytokine storm can also affect the brain by disrupting normal neuronal signaling or brain circuits.
So if mood circuits are affected, you can develop depressive disorders or anxiety circuits. You may see panic and anxiety if it hits the sleep center. And we've even seen severe depressions with psychotic features.
Viral diseases are known triggers for psychiatric disorders. Symptoms have been noted in other infectious disease outbreaks, including influenza, herpes, HIV/AIDS, Ebola, MERS, and SARS-CoV.
What is really concerning is when we see the patient who does not have any prior history, and there's no history of illness in the family, who presents with a marked change in behavior that's traceable directly in a time-wise to having had the infection starting within weeks.
I'm not a dark person. I'm joyful most of the time, and I try to see the glass half full, but this was a total 180.
Medication, therapy, and the support of a dear friend helped save Mac's life.
At one point in my life, I was prideful. You know, well, we can get through this. We can pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. But this is not something that you want to play around with.
It wasn't my husband stressed or upset because he had been in the hospital with COVID. This was something that had taken him over, and it was no longer my husband. Had I known about this, I would never have let him out of my sight ever that day.
Jennifer says she's heard from families all across the country who need help or who've experienced a similar loss due to COVID psychosis. She spent the last year lobbying in her husband's honor. And now there's new legislation that, if passed, will help fund research on neurological and psychiatric illnesses associated with COVID-19. We have more information and resources on our website, including the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline. That number, 800-273-8255. Back to you.